Hey, it's Patrick here from the GarageBandGuide.com. In this video, I'm going to take you through some different ways you can connect your guitar to your Mac so that you can record it in GarageBand. First things first though, by far the quickest and easiest way to record your guitar into GarageBand is to position your Mac's built-in microphone in front of an amplifier, hit record and start rocking out. The results, however, will be less than stellar and pretty much useless for all but the roughest of the rough demos. You absolutely can put an external microphone in front of your amp, hit record and get much, much better results. But in this video, I'm going to focus on some different gear that allows you to plug your guitar directly into your Mac. The cheapest way that I could find to DI or directly input your guitar to a Mac is via one of these quarter-inch jack to USB cables. I got this one for around £6 on Amazon, but you can find better quality examples of them from other brands and sellers. It's dead easy to use, just plug one end into your guitar, the other end into your Mac, and provided you already have it open, GarageBand will automatically recognize it as an input. An issue you may run into, especially if you're using a cheaper solution like this quarter-inch jack to USB plug, is latency. Now, latency essentially is the length of time between when you would play a note on your instrument and it registering inside your DAW, in this case in GarageBand. Now, there's no way to change the settings of this in GarageBand, so if you find that you are having very, very high levels of latency, like I am with this particular cable here, there's no way to fix that from within GarageBand itself. Other DAWs do have the option, you can adjust buffer sizes and things like that, so bear that in mind if you plan on getting a cable that's as cheap as the one that I got. Not only that, but when I plugged this cable in, it seemed to be making some kind of strange Morse code-like sound. Either that or, you know, it was contacting the mothership to come and collect me. One of the two things. Either way, it makes the whole thing pretty unusable. So make sure that you are getting a good deal, that you're buying from somewhere that if it doesn't work with your version of GarageBand, you can always return it. So here's how the quarter-inch jack to USB cable sounds. Again, as I mentioned before, bear in mind I was dealing with quite a bit of latency, so that's why the playing and the recording is a little bit crap. The next step up from that is something like this. Small portable interfaces like this one have become incredibly popular in recent years, particularly with those using iPads and iPhones. That's not to say super portable interfaces aren't suited to Mac users as well. In fact, if you're only looking to DI a single instrument at a time, they make a great budget alternative to a fully fledged audio interface. I'm using an iRig Pro IO from IK Multimedia in this case, which also has an XLR input for attaching a microphone. But units like IK's iRig HD and Apogee's Jam series include a single quarter-inch jack input that's perfect for recording guitars. These interfaces often come with several connection types, allowing you to use them with a variety of different devices. To attach the iRig I have here to my Mac, I'll need to use the USB connection. GarageBand will again automatically recognize that an audio interface has been attached and as long as track monitoring is enabled, you'll be able to hear yourself play. Sound quality is also greatly improved, with clean sounds actually sounding clean and driven tones much clearer and controlled. Here's an idea of how one of these interfaces sounds. Finally, the pro way, but also more expensive way to DI your guitars into GarageBand is to use an audio interface. If you want the best possible quality recording of your guitar, or any instrument for that matter, then using an audio interface is the way to go. From cheaper single input interfaces to professional grade FireWire units with dozens of input and output options, there's definitely a lot of choice when it comes to choosing an audio interface. I'm using a Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 interface here, which runs for about 100 quid new, but other popular interfaces like the Prosonus Audio Box or M Audio Fast Track are great options too. Interfaces like these are pretty straightforward to use. Connect the interface using the USB plug, and GarageBand will once again automatically recognise that an external audio interface has been connected. Plug your guitar into the desired input, and away you go. A quick tip here, I find with my interface that GarageBand will automatically assume that I want to use the interface as both an input and an output source. Now that is handy if you have studio monitors attached, but not that handy if you want to listen to what's being played through headphones that are attached to the Mac's headphone jack. Heading to GarageBand's preferences menu, selecting audio / MIDI, and then selecting built-in output from the output drop-down menu fixes this. So here's an idea of how audio recorded through an audio interface sounds. So there you have it, that's three ways you can connect your guitar to your Mac so that you can record it in GarageBand. If you found this video helpful, then hit the like button, I really do appreciate it, and it lets me know that you want to see more videos just like this one. If you're not subscribed already, then now's a great time to do so, and don't forget to hit the notification bell there to make sure that you don't miss a thing. I've been Patrick from thegarageBandguide.com, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.